matter, sir? You have my everlasting gratitude, sir. America has no need for your services,
gentlemen. Send them back to Britain in a box. Death to the oppressed!
Cut them down!
From the tax office, for example.
Excuse me. Might I impose upon the kindness in your heart to give bed and board to a weary traveler?
Oh, traveler from where?
Across an ocean. London.
English!
Rest assured, I'm not the king's man. A great kindness. Bless you.
We work hard for what we have here, old man. What is it you do exactly?
I wish to provide God for those who seek his salvation, not spoon-feed his word to those who already have their own. An outlook not shared by the monarchy.
Lord knows some of us have things to confess.
Ollie and I have been missing our Sunday Mass.
I'd like Maria to read the Bible. I'm sure if we all pitched in, we could build a church. If you'd be our pastor. Connor?
Welcome, Minister...
Father. Father Timothy. We are smiled upon. Bless you. This will build a fine place of worship. I am most grateful. The stars are coming out.
Prudence, are you all right? What are you doing out here in the woods?
Thank goodness! The baby's coming!
We need to get you to Dr. White.
No! I can't move! Take my horse! Bring him here!
Dr. White, come with me now. What's wrong? Prudence is in labor in the forest.
In the forest? What in bloody hell is she doing out there?
Does not matter.
We need to get water.
Now?
Yes!
Are you here?
Over here. What's the trouble? Where is she?
Tell me how she seemed to you.
In great pain. She could not move herself.
Was she pale? Was there blood?
Not that I saw.
Might be we have some time.
We must hurry!
Thank you.
Hello, Doctor. I think I can manage at the moment.
Is she all right, Doctor?
No, she's not all right. She's having a baby, and here, by the looks of it. Yes. Looks to be in fine health as well. Has a good set of lungs on him. Now, I don't mean to rush you, but we need to get both you and... Does he have a name yet?
Hunter.
Connor? I don't mean to be a bother, but I wanted to ask you something. When my cart went up in flames, I lost most of my tools. I've got some spares back at my shop in Boston, but as you know, I'm not really welcome around there. I thought if it wasn't too much trouble, you could help me retrieve them?
What would you have me do?
Watch my back while I gather them. Meet me in Boston at my old shop.
Day, Connor. I left some bolts of fine silk in my old home. They are very valuable, but I don't think it wise I return there. Someone might wind up dead. I was hoping you could retrieve them for me if you had time.
I have the tools you requested.
Ah, excellent. I'll get right to work. Norris has been hanging around pestering me about his knife.
I thought you should know I overheard some regulars talking. They are looking for you.
I imagine they are. I'll have to face them sometime or another.
smoke, Connor?
No, thank you.
We were just recalling the eventful day of Little Hunter's birth.
I am not sure I have ever been so anxious.
Ha! I barely remember a thing up until the moment I heard him cry. Then it all slows down, and I recall every little detail. From Hunter's wailing face, to Prudence's teary eyes filled with pure love, to the smell of the mud and the leaves. I've never been as happy as I was in that instant.
Things in this house sound right.
Norris, what are you doing out here?
I want to give Miriam her knife. Maybe you come with me?
Of course. What is keeping you?
I am nervous.
I am certain she will love the blade you made for her.
What am I doing? Giving a woman a knife as a gift? It's so stupid.
This is something she will appreciate and use.
Ugh. I made the stupid thing. I might as well give it to her.
Where?
Hello, Miriam.
Hello, Norris. Hello, Connor. I'd love to stay and chat, but I promised Ellen a bale of furs this week, and I'm not even close to making good. I need to get out into the bush right away.
Two hunters are better than one. I can help if you like.
Would you? I'd be much obliged.
I bring something for you. Maybe, it will help?
I really must get moving. I will thank you properly when I get back. Until then... meet me at my northernmost hunting blind after you take your first skin.
Thank you.
time for forgiveness has passed.
Please don't kill me. I'll never come back. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I won't come back again. I swear it. Please, mister.
Had this blade, that lick spittle might have gutted me.
A timely gift from Norris, it would seem.
Indeed. I must make sure to thank him properly.
sailors of the first watch.